So the question is now, so how many frequencies can we encode? And remember, we are in a sample system here. So we've got samples. And we've got also the symbol duration t. Symbol duration t. Obviously here, no, really also in samples. What previously I swept this slightly under the carpet, but here we need to really take care of this. So let's look, what is the lowest frequency we can encode? So lowest frequency. And that's pretty straightforward if we think about that. And this is determined by our symbol duration t. So remember, these are still samples here. So we have here n, and this is our x of n. And so obviously, the lowest frequency is just that we are able to put in one sine wave in it here. So that's our lowest frequency. So that's essentially, this is just 1 over t is our lowest frequency. So obviously with that we are limited. And so now the question is, so what is our highest frequency we can encode? So what's the highest frequency? And here, remember, we've got again samples. So we've got samples, remember. We have samples. So let's plot this here again in our sample domain. So that's n. And so the highest frequency we can encode, we just need to have at least one peak and one valley. And then we alternate that. And so on and so on. So this is the highest frequency. And so the highest frequency is obviously then half fs. So that's our sampling rate of our OFDM system. And that's the highest frequency the determines that. So let's now look a bit closer at the discrete Fourier transform.